A big round of applause. We are right now in Pioneer Square. This is the oldest part of Seattle. It's known as the original downtown. And notice all the brick buildings we're surrounded by. Well, it all came about after the Great Seattle Fire of 1889. When they rebuilt the city after the Great Seattle Fire, there were two rules that were in place. Rule number one, no combustible materials were allowed in the reconstruction of Seattle. That's why we've got all the brick buildings. And rule number two, they wanted to build up off the tide flats. It used to be quite a problem. The tide would come in and literally back up the plumbing. Well, they did a good job of this. Almost. The ground floor shops had already opened when the engineers of Seattle raised the streets 10 feet above the tide flats. It took 20 years before they eventually raised the sidewalks to street level. When they did this, they encapsulated underground Seattle. You can take a walking tour and be on underground Seattle tour on your left-hand side. You guys, goodbye, you guys. It's haunted down there. Hope to see you again someday. They're on an underground tour right now. It's very rich in Seattle history. I'd be more than happy to show you where you can get those tickets. Any of those people on my earlier duck tour today? Oftentimes they are. That's a really interesting tour. Hey, you guys, you see that green umbrella on the corner right there? Do you know that's a Starbucks coffee, everybody? Cha-ching. Great job, everyone. So Pioneer Square, it really is the original downtown Seattle, and it is known as the oldest part of Seattle. Now coming up on your right-hand side, this really is Pioneer Square. There's a covered walkway right there, that's called a pergola. And immediately to your right, there's a large Native American totem pole right there. If you look past it over your right shoulder, there's a bronze bust of Chief Sealta. And your underground tour tickets? Well, there's a big green neon sign that says Underground Tour. All right, you guys, I want to take you uptown right now and show you the hardest working man in Seattle. Are you ready to go? Yeah. All right, we're on our way.
Can't touch this.
Good job, buddy.
I told you, homeboy, can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living in your snow. Can't touch this. Look at my eyes, man. Can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you want to dance. Move out of your seat and get a fight. Go and touch this while it's rolling. Hold on. Pump a little bit and let it know what's going on. Like that. Like that.
Ladies and and gentlemen, the hardest working man in Seattle is Hammering Man. He's the icon of Seattle Art Museum. He's right there, and he stands 48 feet tall, weighs in at just 26,000 pounds. Seattle Art Museum is truly world-class. It encompasses an entire city block, over 118,000 square feet. And the art there is from all over the world. It's from Europe, it's from the Americas, it's from Asia. And the art in Seattle Art Museum exceeds $1 billion. And in the entrance to Seattle Art Museum is a beautiful chandelier created by world-renowned glassblower, Mr. Dale Chihuly. And Dale Chihuly is a local Seattle